Let's go.
Tonight on Bands Reunited.
More than words to show you feel.
Extreme. This Boston band hit it big in 1991 with the surprise acoustic smash. A surprise because...
we're a hard rock and roll band.
And the success of More Than Words was, the whole blessing and a curse.
A curse because these hard rockers couldn't shake their soft rock image. After struggling for 5 years, they finally called it quits.
Extreme's over. It's done.
We've got just 7 days to reunite Extreme.
Gary Cherone.
We're going to travel America.
Pat Badger.
Find the band members, Nuno Bettencourt, and bring them back together again.
That's not going to happen.
You can't make somebody do something they don't want to do.
We need a good fist fight.
In the late 1980s, the big-haired hard rockers of Extreme seemed to get lost in the rock and roll shuffle. Until they amped down with a love song. More Than Words took the nation by storm, hitting number one and thrusting the band into the national spotlight. But the fans never shared the band's love for hard rock.
I could never say that, you could ever resent a hit song.
But resent it, they did, as their soft rock overshadowed their harder songs such as... Kid Ego. And... Little Girls. But as record sales fell, creative differences arose between singer Gary Cherone, guitarist Nuno Bettencourt, bassist Pat Badger, and drummer Paul Geary, causing an extreme breakup in 1996.
Nuno called me and he goes, "What do you think if I quit the band?" And I was crushed.
Guitarist Nuno Bettencourt broke all ties and lead singer Gary Cherone joined Van Halen.
I just remember telling everybody, going, "I'm going to LA to sing Jump."
Can we get the four members of Extreme to come together for one final performance?
You gotta walk softly.
The mission is extreme, but not impossible.
We begin by going to Extreme's hometown of Boston. Lead singer Gary Cherone is our first challenge.
You're gonna pull into this parking lot. You're gonna walk down this pathway.
Yeah.
You're gonna go to that door right there.
Yeah.
Open the door and then go inside. You're gonna see mailboxes on the left. And it says G. Cherone.
We gotta be ready to rock and roll.
That's him right there.
Is it?
Oh my God.
Yeah, I recognize the thing hanging on it. Mirror.
Back up, no, not too close.
We're on our way to Gary Cherone's house, and we're right behind him.
Oh, sorry, Dad.
We're not gonna let him go in his place, are we?
No.
Hi, Gary Cherone?
Yes.
From Extreme? My name's Amir from VH1.
All right.
Do you have a second?
Is this a joke?
No, honestly.
Let me see some credentials, man.
Okay.
Is that on?
Yeah.
Could you turn it off, please? Yeah. How'd you guys know where I live?
Oh, Gary, come on. We're VH1. We know where all you guys are. That's me right there. I propose to you, my friend, a one-off reunion with the members of Extreme. Are you in for the reunion?
When?
Next week.
You're kidding me?
No, honestly.
What, to play?
To play.
That's near impossible in a week.
Gary was unwilling to sign on right away, so we decided to talk to him in more comfortable surroundings.
Heard you were building a house.
Yeah, it looks like a fort I built in junior high school.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I guess we could go up there.
Okay.
You guys want to follow me?
Why don't you take us on a tour?
All right. Bathroom, closet, master suite, cathedral ceiling, all that stuff.
Did you ever imagine yourself at this stage in terms of your career when you started out?
I can honestly say I feel the same way now as I did 20 years ago. I love what I do. I'm actually fortunate enough to be able to do it for a living.
More more than words. What about the words themselves? What inspired you?
Thanks for asking. Yeah. This is a very misunderstood song. Actually, the song was written from my girlfriend's perspective. So I'm singing it as she would say it.
Say it, I love you is not the words I want to hear from you.
I guess saying I love you wasn't enough. She heard it and heard it and heard it, and I wasn't showing her. It's basically actions speak more, you know, louder than words.
Then you wouldn't have to say that you love me, 'cause I'd already know.
Actually, that's the first time I'm able to explain it. It was from my girlfriend's perspective.
It's very interesting to hear that a song that did so much for you on the one hand was something that you grew to hate, as you said.
We resented it. We never hated it.
A lot of people come up to us and go, you're the guys that do that more than words song right there. We like that song. We don't like any of the other songs.
It didn't represent 9/10 of the band, and it was only the two of us. And I wonder if that was the beginning of the end.
What led to Nuno deciding that he'd lost the passion?
No, he didn't lose the passion. I think it was a combination of telling his own story and wanted to say something lyrically. I was trying to keep the band together, trying to come up with some ideas, let Nuno do his thing, but Extreme was done. Officially, maybe spring, summer of 96. Fall of 96, I joined Van Halen. That was a whirlwind. That was pretty incredible. 3 years, a record, a tour.
The important question right now, Gary, the pressing question is, are you in for this reunion?
To this day, it's always been, for me, unfinished business. I always thought that we just started. So to me, doing somewhere down the road, I would love to do records with Extreme.
Right.
But it would have to be United.
I just wanted to wrap up by asking you about where I can track some of your bandmates down. First of all, Nuno, how can I find him?
He's been in LA for, over a year.
Okay.
And you gotta walk softly.
Oh, okay.
Don't piss him off.
Oh, is he volatile? Is that what you're saying? He's got a temper?
No, he's into the music.
What about Pat?
He's a farmer.
Okay, all right.
Pat's up north. He's semi-retired father now.
Gary, pleasure to meet you, my friend.
Thank you
so much.
I want to thank everybody for invading my privacy.
And it's like you're accepting an award.
Yes.
With the plans.
On behalf of me and my plans and my house. Leave.
Okay.
We leave Gary with a promise to stay on his back until he agrees to the reunion. Next. With Extreme's lead singer Gary Cherone refusing to consider reuniting without a united front.
I would love to do records with Extreme, but it would have to be united.
Each ambush has become more critical.
We are about to welcome onto the property of Pat Badger, bassist for Extreme.
Pat now owns and operates an alpaca farm. That's a domesticated llama. We have no idea where he's going to be, outside, inside the house. There's someone outside with someone else. They see us. They're looking at us, we're looking at them. Hi, I was looking for Pat Badger.
That's me.
That's you? Pat Badger from Extreme? Hey,
yeah.
Hi, my name's Amir from VH1. Pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you. What do I have the pleasure?
I was wondering if you would be interested in reuniting with your band for a one-night-only gig.
You name a place and the time, I'll be there.
You're in?
You gotta get the other guys to do it.
I'll be in, Isaac! Are you kidding me? All right, that's awesome. Welcome aboard.
Reuniting with Extreme would definitely be a fun thing to do. You know, it's one of those things, like, just when you think you're out, they suck you back in.
He's in! Let's hear it.
Pat's on board, and he offered us a tour of his farm.
Hey, while you're here, you got to check out my alpacas. So I'm kind of rock star turned farmer.
Well, but tell me about them. What are these guys all about?
Well, they're actually they're like a smaller version of a llama, but they produce fiber that's like softer than cashmere and warmer than wool.
Do you ever play music for them, your old songs for them? I'm gonna see how they react. Let me just see how. I think he recognizes it. Oh my gosh, I think it's inspired them.
You know, that song gets you in the mood.
I want to talk more about your days with Extreme, but I also want to talk about, like, what you do. I mean, tell me about this place.
Well, my wife and I just had a baby.
Oh, congratulations.
So I have a four-month old little boy, and I mean, that has been the most thrilling thing.
I guess what I would want my son Aiden to know about Extreme, you know, you really should try to reach for your dreams, because that, you know, without sounding corny, that was something that was kind of a one-in-a-million shot for any band. And so, you know, whatever he wants to do, I hope he goes for it.
Was More Than Words, in your opinion, Pat, a double-edged sword in that it obviously gave you a lot of success and opened many, many doors for you, but at the same time, it pigeonholed you? Did you grow to resent that song individually and as a band?
I could never say that, you know, you could ever resent a hit song. I mean, you know, we were lucky and blessed that song was as big as it was. Yes, it was, like, you know, in some ways a double-edged sword. You know, it kind of created a misperception as far as, you know, it didn't give the whole scope of Extreme. Great thing is we did, you know, turned a lot of people onto music, you know, that may not have heard us before. So one song actually got people into the band and said, wow, this is really cool stuff, you know, they're a diverse band.
Pat, I'm gonna need a hand in tracking down your fellow band members. What about Paul, what's he up to?
Paul Geary is in Medford, Massachusetts.
Okay.
He's got his own management company.
So we make the short drive back into town to find drummer Paul Geary.
GAM, Global Artist Management. That's where we'll find Paul Geary, now a manager for bands like Godsmack, Cold, and Fuel. Stairs? I was looking for Paul Geary, please.
Yes, you are.
He's on the phone. Hi, Paul. Hi, my name's Amir, I'm from VH1. Nice to meet you, sir. I'm here on a very important mission. I've been given the assignment, the task, the pleasure, if you will, of trying to get one of the great bands of all time back together again, that band being Extreme. So the reason I'm here is to talk to you about the good old days, to talk to you about the times you had with them, but more importantly, probably most importantly, to ask you if you would be open to getting back on stage with your old bandmates for a one-off gig.
So talk about on the spot here.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, all you have to do, my friend, is show up and play and have a good time. We'll take care of it. So are you into that?
Oh, I'm in.
He's in! Welcome aboard. Welcome aboard, Paul. That's awesome. To seal the deal for us, if you wouldn't mind, sir, just give us your autograph. Tell me about the good times that you had. Yeah, anything comes to mind in terms of stories?
When I was a kid, maybe 17 years old, and this was in the 70s, and Aerosmith was in their height of debauchery. It was the first concert I'd ever gone to, and I was at the Boston Garden, and I was sitting out there, and the band came on and began to play, and I was overwhelmed, and I thought, oh my God, this is from another world. And wouldn't you know it, that 10 years later, the first break that Extreme got was opening for Aerosmith at the Civic Center here in New England. And as I began to perform in this arena, I started crying. It was like I transgressed 10 years, and there I was, and I just flipped right from there to the stage. And I could see some of the Aerosmith guys on the side of the stage watching, and here they were watching me.
More Than Words, how did that change your life as an individual in the band and the lives of everyone in the band?
They put it out while we left for Europe, and it was astounding what happened. And the calls were coming in from our families and everything that, you know, VH1 and MTV were pounding this thing. Just days before we headed back to the country, we got the call and said that it was the number one song in America. Just by saying I love
you. Tell me a little bit about day-to-day life for you now.
Now my day is pretty much being connected with my bands, making sure that they're happy, and right. And now I'm actually more successful than I've ever been.
The schedule we have mapped out, we're looking at next week. Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
That's amazing. I mean, I haven't played drums in years, but you know what? I'd love to do it. We need a good fist fight, I think. They gotta get us in a room and let us really go for it. It's overdue. We never did it, and who knows what'll come out of that. Maybe we'll form a band.
All is in, and it looks like we're making progress with putting Extreme back together. We head back to LA to track down the elusive guitarist, Nuno Bettencourt.
You gotta walk softly.
Oh, okay.
Don't piss him off.
Nuno Bettencourt, the musical mastermind, the genius of Extreme, is having a lunch with one of our colleagues just around the corner. Nuno Bettencourt, my name is Amir from VH1. How are you?
I'm here to ask you a very important question. Would you be willing to reunite with your former bandmates for a one-time-only performance?
Nuno responds with an emphatic no and refuses to appear on camera. Total shutdown. With the Extreme reunion very much in doubt and guitarist Nuno Bettencourt refusing to take part, we fly lead singer Gary Cherone to Los Angeles in a last-ditch effort to make this reunion happen.
Welcome to Los Angeles. I left New England with the idea that we were on the right path. And so it surprises me that we weren't able to do
this. Well, I did talk to Nuno afterwards, and we both agreed that for us, for at least for me and Nuno, it would be taking a step back. Let me see. You know, Extreme was a rock band, and the success of More Than Words was a, you know, the whole blessing and a curse, put the band on the map, but then we were fighting the rest of our career. You know, the band ran its course, some things went down, and so that's why Extreme won't be around anytime soon.
These unresolved issues?
Well, they've been in the air since 96.
Oh, okay, so they really haven't gone away?
No.
It's just more...
No, and, you know, we've all been through a lot, and so, in the end, you know, we're brothers, but, you know, as far as Extreme getting back together, that's not gonna happen.
I kind of gave up waiting for it to happen a long time ago, and, maybe someday the planets and stars will align and we'll play together.
You know, hope everyone's doing well out there. And you know, I think eventually it'll happen again. I hope so.
The guys in Extreme just would not reunite. This is reality television, and that is a sad reality. Trust me, we're as disappointed as you are.
Hey, pal.
What's up, Nat? I wish life was as smooth as a peach pit milkshake.
What's wrong?
I got a date for the Wilson Phillips concert, but it's the same night I Love the 90s premieres on VH1.
Buzzkill.
You're breaking our date? As if. But, talk to the hand.
You go, girl!
Yeah!
That's right.
Whatever. I'm outie.
Wait, why don't you watch I Love the 90s together?
I Love the 90s.
It's too soon.
It's not till July 12th.